All right, here's Eric walking in. Doesn't he look beautiful? Lundqvist, Subban have a competition right now. Look at the way he walks. Looks good, eh? Beautiful. That's good. I like that. Yes, little wave there. Very nice. All right, where are you now? In Newfoundland, Jimmy Bird, eh? All right, go ahead. Where are you?
Jimmy Bird country is Corner Brook, Newfoundland, Don. And the last time you'll remember, by the way, he looks like James Cook, the captain, doesn't he? Remember how the last time we had a little trouble with the Cook when I was in Newfoundland? But James Cook actually did all the shoreline here. Amazing. They still use the maps he did in the 1700s today.
One of my favorites. I got a ship right up in my living room. I love James Cook. You know what happened to him, eh? I better not go into it. All right. No, what do you got here? All right.
Josh Donaldson, I want to congratulate you. MVP.
MVP. Was there any choice? I mean, it was automatic. MVP, there he is. Josh Donaldson should have been. He'll be back. Blue Jays are going to be great next year.
James Reimer, Don, all week, and you saw a little something in the first period tonight?
Well, I saw some little tap here. You young defensemen always have your defensemen. Don't forget they're there. I mean, this is the game before against Carolina. Watch the saves here. They got outshot. The 60% in, look at that save there, 60% on the draws. Every guy, five guys were minus on the Leafs. Five guys were plus. I know it's hard for you to understand. And they won the game because of that guy tonight, given us is the best right now. I'm saying right now, the best goaltender in the National Hockey League right now. Terrific. He is keeping him in there. He's number one, should be number one all the time. Go ahead.
Great. Good night for the Canadian teams last night, Don. But in Alberta, for the Oilers, a huge win. And Taylor Hall leading the way there.
Cakes and Ontario boy Taylor Hall. He put that. Watch the play here. Dretzkal just you say saucer pass over that. Watch this little saucer pass you say. And while this is going on, I'm going to tell you a story. I was at a Marley tournament. Now watch this here. I was at a Marley tournament, and he was just a kid. He was a minor midget, and the guy says, "Well," he said, "Oh, watch how he asked when he scores a goal. He doesn't jump around. Stupid way to go." And the guy said, "Pick the best player." And Kingston got beat 3-0, and I picked Taylor Hall, and the guy got mad at me. I said, "You picked the best player. Got two goals in the afternoon." All right, keep her going.
Calgary now 5-0, 3-on-3 in overtime. Amazing.
Come on, pick it up. This is, you know, we're doing our best here, eh? All right.
I'm a half hour later. I'm doing the best I can.
All right. Johnny Canuck, watch this guy put her in here, the winner right here. Johnny Canuck, an American, I got to say, does pretty good for a little guy. But the guy that gets me, TJ Brody, you know how much he played the other night? 32 minutes. Watch him block shots. There is nobody on defense playing like this guy. TJ Brody, 32 minutes. He is a rock back there. He's taking over Giordano right now.
All right, your dark horse for the Calder Trophy Rookie of the Year, St. Louis Blues.
Colton Parayko. Oh, I said it pretty good. This guy from St. Albert. Nobody's ever heard of him. He's getting goals. He's third in all defenseman goals. He's plus 10, second best. And get this, he's first in five at goals for all defensemen, rookies like this. And we got a little picture of his mom and dad and family this year. You never even heard of this guy, did you? There he is right there. His first two goals, his first game. Never even heard of me. You're going to hear from him in the future right now. Ready to go, Colton.
Hey, Don, because you're going to do such a nice thing on Kevin Bieksa, why don't we save Matt Duchene for next week?
Poor Matt.
You could do a real nice. Yeah,
all right,
Kevin Bieksa always made you smile. Yeah.
All right. Kevin Bieksa, one of my favorite guys of all time. He fights Fisher. Fisher's got a mask on. But watch this here. Watch his tooth. It's hanging by a nerve, and he keeps going. He is my type of guy. I'll tell you one thing. Watch the tooth come out. And he keeps right on going. That's old-time hockey, boys. And he keeps going. We don't show you because your kids might be watching. But anyhow, he gets a tooth knocked out. Now, here he is the second game. My buddy Derek, I can't believe it, Derek McKenzie, used to when he was Jeff Rimmer and that. He wants trouble. So Bieksa drops the clubs and watch what he does. Derek McKenzie. And Gudmundsson come in. He was embarrassed about the whole thing. Derek McKenzie, a McKenzie clan, I can't believe it. Ah, but the hockey gods come through. Look at that, he laughs. He went in the bench and the players turned. But look what happens on that penalty, Cogliano. And hockey gods come over and the winner goes in. Derek, never do that again. Way to go, perfect. Then they won the game and I'm happy about that. I couldn't believe it, a McKenzie turned down a fight and then laughed. Okay, what's next?
Oh, well, unbelievable. David Backes, St. Louis, goes after Jarmelson. You found this, too.
All right. Watch this here. Everybody says, who would you like to start a franchise with? This is a guy I'd like. Taves right here. Robinson gets hit. Now, watch. This is the MVP of the league. Stanley Cup winner, captain. Taves takes him on. And Backes, he's a good guy, too. I really like him, too. They've had about three fights. But there's Taves, MVP guy, Stanley Cup winner. He gets ahead. He sticks up for his teammates. What a guy. I love that, Jonathan. And he says, I can't tell you what he says. I like Backes, too. I really think. Now.
That's fantastic. Hey, Grapes, can I just say, because you're going to take the two men here and deal with this two beautiful stories.
Sure.
I was in Corner Brook a few years ago for the Canadian Paraplegic Association. Ed Smith was the keynote speaker, who had a spinal cord injury in 99, and he's doing great. I talked to him this week. Writes for the St. John's Telegram. Fantastic guy. So I know for the Pettingers, I just want to promise them better days, full life, all that. We don't know all the details yet, but for Braden, and Aaron Ashton plays here, senior hockey don. He's from Portage La Prairie, so a lot of people thinking of Braden, but over to you.
Well, I'm going to talk next week about it. There's Braden right there. He had a tough luck. He went into the boards, and I'm going to talk more about it. I mean, doesn't he look like a good kid, a good plays for the Portage La Prairie? I mean, I'm going to talk more about him when I got more time next week about the whole thing, because we can help him like that. And now we're going to talk about a Princess Pat guy. There he is, John Roberts Gallagher, over there, right there. Gallagher, he's a good Irish boy, and he was over there fighting. He killed in action. There he is, the Princess Pat. And you know, you talk to the Princess Pat, once a Princess Pat, always a Princess Pat. He was only 28 years old. He was over there, he was killing that. And I feel for his mom, Valerie, 28 years old, John Robert Gallagher.